sailors who fish for your pay. I'll sing you a song from a time when they say that the salmon ran thick and were heavy as sin, and the canneries caught 'em and wrapped 'em in tin. It was haul away, Johnny, and haul again strong. You'll be hauling these nets for the whole season long. So attend to the story of what can go wrong if you're sailing to Pyramid Harbor. We had signed on in Frisco for less than you'd wish, $50 a person and 2 cents a fish. So we needed to catch all the fish we could get. Then we heard that our ship had the wrong kind of net. But it's haul away, Johnny, and haul again strong. We'll be hauling these nets for the whole season long. So attend to this story of what can go wrong if you're sailing to Pyramid Harbor. So we went to complain to the cannery's boss, but he told us those nets shouldn't cause any loss. You know, for our profits, we need those fish too. So we've chosen the nets both for us and for you. And it sounded convincing, or so I first thought, 'cause I never had copies of Gets Work with Scott, where they ask what incentive a company learns if it pays all the costs but must share the returns. So the others rejected the boss's defense, but the step they took next didn't make too much sense. They said to the boss he must double our pay, or we'd walk off the job on that very same day. Now we all of us knew that this wasn't too shrewd, 'cause the canneries owned all the ships and the food. You don't walk off a ship in some far northern bay. But the boss said, you win and we'll double your pay. Then hurrah for the boss who's the fisherman's friend. We returned to our work thinking we could depend on that promise to double our pay in the end when we got back from Pyramid Harbor. Now it's haul away, haul away. So we all thought our boss was unusually kind, but he may have had something more canny in mind. When we got back to Frisco and asked for our pay, we politely were told we could jump in the bay. Then they spoke of our duty and spoke of our greed, and they said we'd exploited the cannery's need. We had already promised the work that they got, and a promise is sacred.
Sure. Well, but what about his promise?
Ah, what about his? A promise is sacred, except when it's not. Now there's some of you here who may well disagree over who's the exploiter and who's exploitee. But the practical lesson is clear at a glance. When exploiting a canner, get cash in advance. And remember this song when you're safely in port. Though your pay may be nasty and brutish and short, you'll do better